Hello and welcome to the course. In the previous lecture, we have seen that how to modify or place the filter context. In this video, we will learn about how to ignore the filter context with the help of calculate function. And here we are using the same data model. We have one student table and the other is the marks table, and we have one to many relationship. So I have added subject on the matrix. Let's add a measure here, total obtained marks, and the formula for this measure is SUMX, and we are providing the first column, first parameter as a table marks, and then we are summing up marks, midterm marks plus final term marks. And I have added one slicer on the report. The star slicer is coming from the student table, and here we can see different student name, student 1 to student 5. And if I click student 1, we will see different subjects marks for the student 1, and then in the same way we can see different marks for the student 2, student 3. And here there are two filters is being applied. One filter is coming from the student name, the other filter is coming from the subject. Now we want to calculate the percentage for each subject marks. So how we will do this? We need to repeat the total with every row so that we can calculate percentage. For this, we need to ignore the filter context that is coming from the subject column. So how we will do this? Let's create one measure. Grand total, we'll use calculate. The first parameter will be expression. We can use the total obtained marks. And now we need to ignore the filter context that is coming from the subject. So we will use a function all. And here you can read the description. It returns all the row in a table or all the values in a column, ignoring any filter that might have been applied. So which filter we need to remove? We need to remove the filter that is coming from the subject column. So we will write subject column and hit enter, and let's drag and drop the matrix. And here you will see we are getting the grand total that is repeating with every row, and it is ignoring any filter that is coming from the subject. So now we have two types of filter. One filter is the internal filter that is coming from this subject and is available within the matrix, and the other filter is the external filter that is coming from the slicer. So when we use all to ignore the filter context, it only ignores the filter context from the inner side. Internal filter context will be ignored, but the outer filter will be still active. So let's see, for the student 3, the total marks is 355. If I click on student 1, it is 356. If I click on student 2, it is 325. So the all function can only remove the internal filters, but it cannot remove the filter that is coming from the external side. So let's write another measure to calculate the percentage. So we will write one measure, subject percentage, and it will be divide, and the numerator will be total obtained marks, comma, the denominator will be grand total. Put into the matrix this measure, and we need to format it. just select this measure and go to the modeling tab, and here we can add, click on the percentage, and here you can choose how many decimal places you want. If I click one, and we will see this is the subject percentage. So in the same way, we can see the percentage of every student by just selecting it. So this is how we can ignore the filter context with the help of calculate. In the next video, we will see some more examples of calculate so that we can better understand how calculate works in DAX.